Welcome to our channel.
What's up? So you're probably wondering who we are. I'm Alonzo Nelson, Olympic track coach, and I coach football players, college collegiate athletes.
My name is Dawn Harper-Nelson, Olympic gold medalist. So, yeah. So today we're going to talk about our reactions, Olympic reaction, right, to the women's 4x1 at the 2016 Olympics.
Let me put on my Olympic
hat. You see
all
the gear? You see all the gear is about to go down. So what happened
USA.
Is
it actually
popped up on my Explorer, and it actually went viral again. So obviously when it happened in 2016, blew up,
but now it blew
up again. And I feel like it's so appropriate with the Olympics being postponed, and now it inspired me so much. I was like, I need to share this with y'all. Like, y'all need to get these reactions, my critiques. If we could have possibly done better, let me answer that right now. No, we killed it. It's not possible. It's not possible for what the women did at the 2016 Olympics to be any better. Like, we won gold. There's nothing else. So shut it down. There's nothing else. What was you about to say? It's nothing else.
I don't know. We're going to see, though, because I got my clock with me. Where's my trusty
He's
clock
He's trying to
at?
Pull out all these stuff behind him. Like, it doesn't matter.
And I got my glasses for extra focus. Let's get to it.
We about to start. So before we get started, you have to understand who is in the race. So it goes USA, Canada, right, Nigeria, Germany, Great Britain, Jamaica, Trinidad and Tobago, and Ukraine. And so we're about to watch the whole race first. You're going to hear me yell a little bit. I can't hold it back. But we're going to watch the whole race, 40 seconds long, because we killed it. And then we'll go back and do some critiquing, if you will. Or just my reaction, because it's no critiques. They killed it.
Hold on. Let me get my clock ready.
Boy, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Fascinating race. An atmosphere.
The nerves, though. Like, why am I?
Here.
I don't know why my heart races.
Right for the start.
Powerhouse nations of sprinting.
Perfect. Anyway, that was perfect. Come on, Tia.
When you catch the person in front, that's the ultimate. Like, you can do no better job for your team.
Perfect. Let's go, Allison.
Like, the other angle that I've seen before is just, it puts in perspective how Allison killed that. The English just, it's a wrap. It's a wrap.
Go, English.
It's a wrap.
Come on, sis. Come on, sis.
It's a wrap. We saw that way. It's like you can't quite tell, but you know, like. Yes, sir.
Come on.
That right there, that turnover, that zooming they did on Tori. Still. Yes, sir.
Woo.
Yes, sir.
Look,
yes, sir. Hey. Okay.
What was that time? Look, what was? Can you see this?
No, what was it? Let me see. I didn't even see.
41:04.
41:01. This is like the first time your clock kind of been right. Whatever.
First time.
Yes.
Okay.
So for me to even try and like calm my nerves right now, like that's hard to maintain because for real, like the first time. No, I'm a track fan.
No. This face is all because of this. Go
okay,
keep talking.
You just really hers. Here, Pat, you got it? You got your pat on the back? Because you feeling yourself. No, but real talk, the first time we watched this, like, I probably was running up, like, we're all in front of the TV.
Yeah.
Like, it was just, because it's like to know each one of these ladies, like, individually, like, this is, it's so crazy. And to know that, like, what they went through before, like, how they really.
They wasn't in the right. It was, and it's always something. It's always something with our 4x1s. Yeah. But, like, for us you know, you just got to get the stick around. All we have to do is get the stick around. So that's for me. I was just like, all right, she got it. Okay. She got it. Okay.
Right.
She got it.
And that's really what I'm like trying to say is that like we knew point blank going in, we brought the best team. Like it wasn't, you know, sometimes, you know, like, no, each leg is about to be a dog fight. And you just really know it comes down to like the exchanges. But this time was straight up like, we know we got the best team. We just got to execute. And then for what happened in a round before, then they had to run by themselves.
Yeah, I think that was the most gangster thing, right?
So
once they got a chance to rerun, they ran it by themselves and qualified for the finals.
By yourself.
Like, and then ran out of lane one. Lane one, like, so as a track coach, everybody hates running in lane one, right? But, like, we've seen time and time again, that's your word. That's what you always say, time and time again. Time and time again, like, we've seen people win the Olympics in lane one.
Yes, we have, because I feel also we paid attention to it. So many times you see people from lane four or five, those are typically like the favorites,
those
four,
the
five,
favorites.
Six, the good lanes. When you get lane one, I feel like people look at, you do, you look at lane one like, oh, like,
you
there's
overlook
no way.
It. It's you over. Don't look at it.
Like one and eight, you're just like, it's over. I don't even know why they're here. They just get to say they're an Olympic finalist. Like, just pat yourself on the back.
The wheels was moving.
Listen, from the beginning, like I said, we just got to go back. Let's just straight up. Let's talk about, like, Tiana.
All right, so look, here go the notes that Harper told us to write.
Why are you trying to put my baby
Harper,
in the
glass? This is what we're reading from. Harper gave us the script. Shout out to my boo
butt. She did. She wrote all over my notes. But that's okay. Like, you're not going to crown my baby because
that's what
we're working
I've been
on
reading.
Our penmanship.
Yes, she's doing good, too.
We're working on our penmanship. So, let's talk about Tiana, like, first leg. Like, you already know, that's first leg.
I don't even know why they focus on...
You got to show everybody.
Nah.
We as fans of USA, but we're talking about Tiana right here. Gun's about to go off.
Those wheels were moving.
Okay, Powerhouse Nations. Set. Yo, it's right there. So, real talk. The way Tiana catches old girl, who is it like, too?
Canada.
The way she called Canada, I'm going to just say it. And I'm not trying to be disrespectful. She passed this chick like she was standing still. I mean, that's something that we say in track and
field. So, what's the jargon? What's the jargon for, like, she got what?
Walked down.
She got ate up. She got ate up. She ate her up.
Okay, is that what you're doing?
Yeah.
Baby shark. You're just a daddy right now because ain't nobody baby shark.
She ate her up,
though.
But
it's the way. I just feel like there's no way. When you make it to the Olympics, there's in the final, there's no way you think you're going to get ate like that. There's no way that can't.
It depends on who behind you.
That's so true.
I don't think she was surprised.
But your feelings hurt. Even though you're not surprised, your feelings hurt. Then you hand it off to Allison AF. Mm-hmm. Allison Phillips.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
Right here. But this angle, when they show the side angle of Allison and this knee lift.
Yeah.
Once again, Nigeria. The exchange that Tiana gave to Allison
was perfect.
It was perfect. And then you see the acceleration of when Allison actually gets the stick. It's almost like she's like, you know what I'm saying? No chains, no bars. Like,
you can tell that they've done this time. They've done this. Throw your word again, time and time again. They've done this over and over. Like, it was perfect. Like, she got out perfectly, and Tiana ran through exchange zone perfectly and gave it a baton, like, with that perfect, like, extension. Put your hand back. Bam! It was just like that.
But remember, the mindset is always catch, walk down the person.
Whoever
is in front of you.
Tiana already did that, so now she got to go to lane four, three.
Allison is like Nigeria. Nigeria, you in my sights.
She got it too.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. She did her job. Yep. Like, you did your job. So now when you do that, you giving the stick off, like, literally, like.
So then we would say that she walked her. She walked her down.
She walked her down.
And Ukraine. I think that's Ukraine. No, that's not Ukraine. That's Germany.
Yeah.
She walked both of them
she
down.
She did.
Yeah.
She walked both of them down. You already see, we getting the stick. You got people playing with their hands back, but they not serious.
My critique, though. The world record is 40.82. They went 41.02.
Yeah.
My clock was 04. Mm-hmm. My perfect clock was 04. Like, if baby girl, little sis.
Who is that?
English.
We know her. You need to say her name.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Oh, y'all don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think if she would have got out a little bit faster, right? Because, like, look, Allison ran up on her.
Hey, yo. Hold up. Faster, and you know what happened in the round before?
Yeah.
No, sir. Well,
this is my hindsight.
We're doing safe exchanges right now
because what we know is we got the speed.
Once we get the stick, we got the speed. Mm-hmm. We have to get the stick around.
She has got to make sure she get it.
Once you get the stick, then no hold. You know what I'm saying? Nothing holding back. Like, it's just let loose. You got to get the stick. English cannot do her job until she gets the stick. I like the exact way that she.
All right, and then for full disclosure. This was the exchange that had them on a bubble, right?
Right.
She dropped.
Right.
So, like, this was an absolute safe exchange.
Safe exchange.
But this was the squad that could have actually broke the world record too, though. Like,
totally
that's all I'm saying.
I agree.
But that was a vet. This is a vet move to make sure that, all right, I'm going to get out enough to make sure that I'm in the exchange zone and I get the baton so I can run. Because you can't run without the baton.
Absolutely.
All right.
Then another thing that you're going to hear a lot of, you hear a ton, I say a gang of screaming on these 4x1s. Because if you get a stick off, it's just a whole bunch of like, da-da-da! I mean, literally, it's the most violent scream that you could give. And it's also, once you get the stick off, that's your
second
extra
to childbirth, right?
Boy, anyway.
That's crazy.
First of all, shut up.
All right, keep going.
English.
Let's go, English.
Here we go. Now this is where he's like zoom. Exactly. Zoom. Like she listen.
Then she just caught everybody else.
The part that's hard with this is we're in lane one, so it's so hard to tell how she did. Now, what I want to talk about this exchange, right? Mm-hmm. So English ate it up, right? Mm-hmm. Literally, I think this part that I saw the video where the dude was like, zoom, like she got, like the way he did his voice was hilarious talking about English. So I heard somebody say, like, I think it was a commentator, was like, oh, they kind of had a slight messy exchange.
Yeah.
There was nothing messy about it. What he saw, because he saw it full speed, so okay.
Yeah.
What he saw was English, she gave a stick off. You sometimes do your hands like this, mm-hmm. and you find yourself kind of, you watching your feet because you don't want to clip the runner in front of actual, like, body, right? And so you legit watching feet, and you're trying to stay in your lane. You're full speed, hand the stick off, and trying to make sure,
trying to walk and chew gum.
Literally. And so with all that going on, it looked like it was a wild exchange. Once you see English doing all this, Tori has a stick and she's gone.
Once again,
beautiful exchange, safe exchange.
It's all the things after the handoff that made it look messy.
Right, right. Yeah. But nah, like English, I'll say this though.
Yeah, it's so hard English to run fast in that skinny curve.
When she gave that stick off, them wheels
were gone.
Listen, English, they was like, gone. I had everything I had. That's what you want though. And then Tori, it's such a beautiful shot they do when they zoom in on her, because it puts in perspective how fast she's moving.
No matter how many times I watch this race, I move as if I can help them, like, go every time.
I'm like,
time.
That's the lean. The finish line is always. And then Tori crossed the finish line 41:02. And then all the screaming and excitement, that's when you finally, like, it's over. Like,
all right, so why do track athletes seem to, like, do all of this stuff, like this screaming and, like, this crying and all of that stuff? Because, like, I think it's too much sarcasm.
I was about to say, okay. I was about to say, what? No, point blank, what it is you've bottled this. Like, you've done all this training. Even when you're running, you have this little bit of, like, nervousness and a little bit of weight on you. Of, like, I got to get the job done. You're like, all that excitement, that's bottled up right here of, like, let me execute. And you did. And
got
you're, like,
job done.
Top so- it's a wrap. That's why we scream and holler and doing cartwheels, crying and backflips.
Right.
Because it's like, it's over. It's almost like, it's over. It's over. Like,
it's like 10 months of training, right? For 41 seconds. 41.02 seconds.
And in your part of it, it's not even 41 seconds.
Yeah. It was 10 seconds.
Oh, my gosh. Lonzo, you and this clock.
Yeah, it was 10
seconds. But straight up. So, point blank, this is part of our reaction to it. Like, to me, it was such a beautiful race because of the comeback from possibly not making the final because of the stick dropping. And so to me, to see how they executed, they were able to put that behind them and then still come forward and pull nothing but vet moves for all their exchanges and get the job done.
Like in a nutshell for me, it's just like us being able to do that, just executing.
Yeah,
because like every year, every championship, it's always
like
something.
It
and for
like
us to
it's
like,
not every. It's 2012, the year before we killed and broke the world record.
It seems like every year, it's always, there's always drama. There's always drama around our 4x1s.
Yeah.
Right?
Always. It is.
Yeah. And so, like, for our athletes to actually get a chance to, like, do it.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And have no hiccups.
Right.
You know what I mean? A conference ago. Yay.
So, we loved it. So, once again, I'm Dawn.
I'm Alonzo.
And so, for more of our reaction, man, and just our life, just hit that subscribe button. I promise it will be entertaining.
Hit that bell, too, so you know we posted something.
Right.
Yeah. All right. Peace.